Hello and welcome to Mad Mondays, Making a Difference Monday. Don't you think life is all about creating positive impact and influences to the people around you in your life? Well, at Malkansview, we work towards this same goal each and every day. So this session is all about, this video is all about helping you bolster up your influence to the people around you, your community, your circumstances, everything. So when you talk about influence, what is the one quality that we admire from the biggest leaders around the world? Leaders who have managed to bring about the change, managed to attract thousands of people in their lives. What is that one quality that really helps them to really influence people around them? And that one quality, if you take any leader, it could be Winston Churchill, it could be Oprah Winfrey, it could be Mahatma Gandhi, it could be anyone. That one quality that really makes them stand out and make a positive influence to people around them is authenticity, which means whatever they say, whatever they feel, whatever they do, and whatever they believe is all aligned to who they actually are. There is no veil that shields their real self from something, from their actual beliefs that they hold. A small tale of Mahatma Gandhi, let me recite it here. It's very common, you've heard it a lot of times, which means a woman walks up to Gandhi to meet him. She comes along with her son in tow, and she's coming to meet Gandhi. She needs a solution for one of her problems. So what she does is, she waits for the whole day and Gandhi is not able to see her. The next day, at the end of day, comes her turn to see the master, and then she goes up to him and she says, "Master, can you please help me? My son just cannot stop eating sweets. He's so much addicted to having sweets, is that I really have to stop him, and at times he can become a cheat, he can become a thief just to have the dose of sweets for himself, and which after having he really throws up tantrums, he spoils his mood, he spoils his health, he spoils his teeth." So what Gandhiji does, he observes the boy for some time, says nothing, and then he says, "Why don't you come after 2 weeks?" Disappointed, the woman just walks away with her son, only to arrive 2 weeks later. So there she meets the master once again and says, "Father, we are back here after 2 weeks. You asked us to come." Again, the master just quietly observes the child, and after a long pause, he tells to the child, "Boy, please don't eat sweets." That's all. The mother says, "You could have said the same words 2 weeks ago." To which Gandhiji replied that, "I could have, but back then even I was having sweets. I would not have asked him to leave sweets when I was having myself." So this is it. This is all about, this was all about it. Gandhiji lived the values that he taught to people. How else do people would have believed him and joined the big movement that he would have just told people that go and join the movement? But he never did that. He led each and every movement that he believed in, and that made people join him. So this is, my friends, if you live by authenticity, you create the best positive impact and influence in the world. When you tell people to make big goals for themselves, to make big vision for themselves, and you yourself go about gossiping about people and doing nothing about your life, it shows in your authenticity. So let's not do that. So I want you to comment on the bottom of the page, what is that one thing that you are ready to believe, to you are ready to do, to live up to your authenticity so that your values and your actions are completely aligned. Thank you very much. This is Meghana Malkan signing off. Keep shining.